Hello, my name's Simon Crafer. This week we're in Thailand at the Chang International Circuit in Buriram. I'm in the Suzuki garage, as you can see, with Alex Rinz's machine. And this week, the Tech Talk is about the advances, especially in technology, that has happened from 2019 to 2022 now. Because I was asked to do this by my colleagues, because a lot of the writers said in Japan that it was totally different in this period, and probably will be here in Thailand as well, and why they wanted to know. So, as we all know, the big differences in technology are the aero and the rear ride height devices. So, just to explain where they've changed things is, basically I learned that to control the wheelie on acceleration is super important. I learned it at Mugello on a 500, because there's lots of second gear accelerations, and you learn to keep the bike on the right angle, because believe it or not, the lean angle lowers the center of gravity and you get less wheelie on this angle. So you learn to control the angle and also to keep your body weight low, because the more you sit up, the more the bike wheelies, and forward for the same reason. But also I learned that putting my backside on the seat sets the wheelie off even more, so you end up standing on the balls of your feet, holding yourself forward, keeping your body low at an angle, and that's how you get the best acceleration. It teaches you how to do this. So wheelie control came in a decade or so later, you know, on production bikes, and basically wheelie control is limiting power. So when the bike starts to wheelie, it cuts the power to hold it there rather than keep going up and you have to close the throttle. But you don't want to limit the power. You need to help the bike accelerate with your body and etc. So the rear ride height devices came in to lower the center of gravity even more. And I got to speak to a test rider at Jerez after he'd first, when they first came out, when he first tried it, and I said, how was it? And he goes, unbelievable. I've been riding laps around this circuit, came out of the last corner expecting the same sort of, or what's the difference? And he said, Simon, it felt like the bike had 30 plus more horsepower in that area. And it's not that it's got more horsepower, it's that the electronics don't cut the power because the bike isn't wheeling. So the result is a massive change in acceleration. I'm talking, like some of the engineers have mentioned at some tracks, 20 meters advance on video of their bike with and without. 20 meters, like, advantage. So that's one of the technology advances. We could go more into ride height devices, how they have advanced from, for example, 2020 to 21, 22, how they've got more controlled in their drop. So to keep the tire, rear tire, from spinning, because if it drops too fast, it'll spin, if it's taking weight off the rear. And if it drops too fast, when it hits the bottom, it causes a wheelie, defeating the purpose. So, but each year, or every month, you know, or every half a year, they've kind of made steps forward again. So, first of all, is the devices, okay? Also, while we're speaking about the back of the bike, the rear tire, in 2020, Michelin came with a new rear carcass construction. And remember, a few riders struggled with it. You know, Dovi would probably be the top of the list. It was, as I understand it, a little bit softer in areas. But the advantage was, if you change the bike setup to suit it and your style to suit it, you had more performance, meaning more grip off the corner, a small step, but you had a good step in durability. So it's not only faster in the rear tire area, but faster consistently over the whole race, meaning race times have come down. So electronic settings would have to change for those two things that we just spoke about, wheelie control and traction control, rear tire grip. Then, referring to my list here, we've got to talk about the next one would be, yeah, efficiency. An engineer, I went digging, and he more or less said all the same things as me, and then he went, efficiency's gone ahead. Meaning, they get the same level of power using less fuel, or which means that they can raise the power up a little bit or the same, and they don't have to reduce power and fuel consumption at the end of the race to make it. They can make it all the way through now because the engine's more efficient. They've figured ways to do it over that period. So the bikes got faster over race distance. And then what else I've got to say about aero. That's the obvious next obvious one. The wings. So they've, we could go on a long time about this, but they have helped not as much as the device in the acceleration area, but they have helped a small step in the acceleration area, especially it's a smaller amount, especially because the wings affect more as the speed raises, you know, and the wind's rushing over it faster. So small help, acceleration, but also they lost a little bit top speed with them because they had to push them. Then they, with the device, because the wings were here before the device, with the device has actually made better aero top speed, you know, aerodynamically, not because, I thought it was because of the wings, they said a little bit because of the wings' angle of attack, but a big bit because the rider is more protected behind the screen in the fairing. Because the back of the bike's down, he's hidden better. His back and shoulders and that are not sticking out in the wind. So they saw a big increase in top speed because of that, because of the device. So aerodynamically, the bikes have got better because of the device and other steps. But also aerodynamics have helped, because they help at higher speeds, pushing the front wheel down, you know, putting weight on the front of the bike. What I noticed when I rode a bike with wings for the first times, the few times I had, is you no longer at the end, you know, the fast turning in point, you no longer needed to close the throttle to put weight on the front to turn in. If you, in my day, if you without wings, you had to do that to get load on the front to turn in. Now you can literally just turn in without delay, you know, so. So they've improved in those areas, but another big step is braking. Because of the weight that wings put on the front wheel, the initial braking can be done harder and quicker, you know, for the same reason. The weight is already on the front. You don't have to close and a little delay that the front weight comes on and then before you pull the brake. Because again, my day, if you did it too quickly, you'd lock the front, but now, the wings already have the weight on the front, so you can do it more quick and harder because it won't lock. So there are all these little steps forward. Then because of the device at the end of the straight, the rear's down more, they can pull harder still because the limiting factor on the brakes, apart from front lock, is the rear coming off the ground. So if the rear's lower, they can initially pull harder until it clicks back into position with the rear. So that's aero devices, and then that puts a lot more force on the front tire. That's why we're seeing more and more. They've been learning how to manage it, but when the devices and wings came in, there was a big jump in front problems with front tire pressure and temperature. Michelin said there's a good percentage in temperature gone up since these devices come, and they see overall, not every team, but on every rider, but overall, the compounds of the front tire choices are higher, meaning harder to cope with that. And the better performance comes from the harder options if the temperature is high enough to use them, because of more stability with the harder compounds. They can brake harder now. So next, can't quite see eyesight. Last one. No, we've done it all. So the real big one to finish on is all of these things affect the lap time. So the lap time and race distance time has got better, you know? So super impressive. Hope you enjoy this tech stuff as much as I do. We'll see you at Phillip Island for the next one. Bye for now.